going on, everybody? Brian here from Brian's Broadcast. I hope all of you are doing fantastic. Summer is finally here, and today I am reviewing the Polo Red Extreme. This is one of the fragrances that I did a first impression on. I'll leave a link of the previous video in the description below, or you can check it out on the top. I'll leave a link over there for your convenience. So don't be shocked, by the way, to look at my new haircut, because the outgrowth was too much. It's too hot right now to maintain long hair, long big hair. So without much delay, let's get down to business. The fragrance I'm going to talk about is Polo Red Extreme from the house of Ralph Lauren. This is the box. Concentration is Parfum, and it's a black, matte black box with shiny logo and lettering. That's the back of the box, top, bottom. Nothing much going on in the sides. Let's get down to the bottle presentation. The bottle is fantastic. Look at this. Looks very elegant, and this is not one of those bottles that you can see through. This black bottle is completely opaque. It's not transparent or translucent. This is what the cap looks like. Very gorgeous. It's a full matte finish on the bottle. I really love it. Let me show you the atomizer. The atomizer has a small red dot. In case you're wondering if you got the authentic stuff or not, the authentic one will have a red atomizer like this. There's nothing on the top. At the bottom, you get the batch code and some information, and that's about it. Nothing on the back. Very simple and elegant bottle design. So now let's get down to the notes. A very simple note breakdown. I even checked their website to verify the facts that I have here on Fragrantica. They all match up, they're all the same. There's nothing extra going on. So, in this fragrance, you got coffee, blood orange, ebony wood. Now, why this particular fragrance is so special to me? Because this fragrance resembles something that I really, really liked. It was one of those fragrances that I just really enjoyed when I had it, but I never realized it would get discontinued, and that particular fragrance is none other than the Givenchy Very Irresistible for Men. You know, that triangular green bottle? It was one fantastic, sweet, dark, gourmand fragrance. If you're into sweet, gourmand fragrances, you guys will know what I'm talking about. Anybody who has sampled that fragrance knows what I'm talking about. So I've looked into a lot of other fragrance notes, a lot of other fragrances, but this one seemed like somewhat close to that, so I went for it. But I was really intrigued by the fact that this fragrance has only three notes: coffee, blood orange, ebony wood. Now when I sprayed it, it was a big blast of good memories. Why I say that? Because this fragrance almost, I would say 95%, resembles the Givenchy Very Irresistible. Reason is, it's got the coffee, it's got the blood orange, the citrusy coffee, invigorating opening. Beautiful opening. I really, really liked it. But although that remaining 5%, why I leave that 5% out is because the Red Extreme does not have that nutty note. You know, like there's this hazelnut kind of feel to this coffee, and the citrusy part, that part is missing in this fragrance. Somehow my nose does not pick that up. Certain people in the community said that they do pick up the nutty note, but I don't get it. I don't believe there is a nutty note. Maybe, of course, like fragrances are, again, they're subjective. So maybe they have that. They feel that, but I don't get it. But there's one note missing that they don't say it on the website or on Fragrantica.com, and it's none other than the chocolate note. There's a bit of this, not too bitter, but you know, slightly bitter kind of chocolatey vibe. It's fantastic, guys. Some may say, you know, like coffee, chocolate, and the citrus, the blood orange part, they might be feeling something synthetic. I did not find it synthetic. The notes, the chocolate, coffee, and the blood orange mixed so nicely with each other. very smooth. The transition is extremely smooth, and once it dries down to that woody, dark, sweet base. Beautiful. Once I spray it, it projects for like an hour or two. And mind you, it's very hot in New York City right now. It's full-blown summer going on right now. So I put this on. I applied like 7 to 8 sprays sparingly, but I tried it. I mean, I had to try this fragrance because it reminds me so much of that Givenchy Very Irresistible. So I had to try this on. And even in this heat, hot, humid day, this thing performed nice. I got a very decent of 6.5 to 7 hours. And mind you, I walk a lot from my house to my workplace and also on the way back home. So my body is constantly sweating, and even in that sweat, hot and humid weather condition, this fragrance performed that much. I'm 100% sure even in the colder month, this performance is gonna be boosted. This fragrance is gonna shine in fall to winter. Definitely it will shine. But guys, do not be thinking that this particular fragrance cannot be used in summer. Very pleasing fragrance, I'm telling you. I got lots of compliments. Ladies dig this because, you know, like gourmand, sweet, chocolate, coffee, the citrus part, it's so invigorating, it's so uplifting, it's so much energizing. You will thoroughly enjoy it. Every day that I have used it, I've really, really enjoyed it. Longevity, like I said, 6.5 to 7 hours, depending on your skin condition and of course the kind of heat or cold weather you're putting it on. I got that much of performance in this hot, humid weather in New York City. About the sillage, it leaves a beautiful scent trail. People around you will notice it, and as you walk past them, they will definitely catch a whiff of it. It's very nice, guys. That was my honest opinion about this particular fragrance. Guys, let me know in the comment section below if you own a bottle of Polo Red Extreme or any other Polo fragrances which you really love, which you really want to share your thoughts about. Let me know in the comment section below, and you guys take care. Stay blessed. And oh, have you subscribed yet? If not, please, please, please do not forget to hit that subscribe button on this channel. Hit the bell icon too. You don't want to miss updates from my channel. Guys, take care. All the best.